In this video, we can discuss about pharmacology of quinolones and fluoroquinolones antibiotics. Here we will discuss the definition, classification, mechanism of action, adverse drug reactions and uses of quinolones and fluoroquinolones. So what is quinolones? Quinolones are a synthetic antimicrobial agents which are having a quinolone structure in it. That's why it is named as quinolone antibiotics. And these are primarily active against gram-negative bacteria. But the fluorinated compounds of quinolones may inhibit gram-positive also. The quinolones includes nalidixic acid as well as fluoroquinolones. So this is the classification of quinolone antimicrobials. There are non-fluorinated quinolones like nalidixic acid and quinolones, fluoroquinolones, like it is again classified into first generation and second generation. In first generation, there are different antibiotics like norfloxacin, ciprofloxacin, ofloxacin and pefloxacin. These are available in market in different dosage form like eye drops and a tablet, etc. Norflox, Ciprox, Oflox. These are some brand name of these antibiotics. And second generation fluoroquinolones are levofloxacin, moxifloxacin, gamifloxacin, prolifloxacin, limofloxacin and saprofloxacin. So it is very easy to remember the quinolones antibiotic by remembering the floxacins. The floxacin will include in the antibiotic quinolones. Now coming to the first type of quinolone, that is nalidixic acid. The spectrum is a narrow spectrum antibiotics. Quinolones alone is, or nalidixic acid is a narrow spectrum antibiotic which will active against gram-negative bacteria alone, especially coliform like E. coli, Proteus, Klebsiella, Enterobacter, Shigella, but it is not active against Pseudomonas. Now coming to the mechanism of action of quinolones, it will inhibit the bacteria by inhibiting its bacterial gyrase enzyme. So it will produce a bactericidal effects. So this is the mechanism of action. DNA require a DNA gyrase enzyme in order to synthesize the or in order to multiply the DNA. But due to inhibition of this DNA gyrase, this DNA synthesis will be inhibited. Thereby, it will inhibit the cell wall. It will inhibit the multiplication, or it will kill the microorganism. It's a bactericidal action. Now coming to the resistance of towards the quinolones or nalidixic acid, usually the resistance to nalidixic acid will develop rather rapidly when compared to fluoroquinolones. Now coming to the adverse drug reactions of quinolones, the commonly seen adverse drug reactions are headache, drowsiness, vertigo, visual disturbances, seizure occasionally, especially in case of children, hemolysis in individual with the G6PD deficiency and phototoxicity, and this is contraindicated in infants. Now it is mainly used as an urinary antiseptic. If there is any urinary tract infection, for their topical action in topical action for the urinary tract infection, it may used as an urinary antiseptic. And it is also used in case of diarrhea due to gram-negative organism like Proteus, E. coli, Shigella or Salmonella. So these are the different uses of nalidixic acid. Coming to fluoroquinolones. Fluoroquinolones are the fluorinated quinolone structure at the position of 6 by introducing an introduction of a piperazine substitution at position 7. It will change into fluoroquinolones. So if you are fluorinating the quinolone structure at the position 6, and introducing a piperazine substitution at position 7 will result, or it will convert quinolones to fluoroquinolones, and thereby its mechanism of action as well as its spectrum will change. So it will produce an inhibition of DNA gyrase in case of gram-negative bacteria. Also, by due to this fluorination, it will inhibit DNA gyrase as well as DNA topoisomerase 4 enzyme. This is found in gram-positive bacteria. So its spectrum will be large, or a broad spectrum. Now, coming to the mechanism of action, fluoroquinolones will bind with the A subunit of DNA gyrase or topoisomerase 2 enzyme, and thereby it will prevent the binding of substrate to the active site of DNA gyrase. Thereby there will be an absence formation of enzyme substrate complex. Thereby it will block unwinding of double stranded DNA into single stranded structure, and it will prevent the synthesis of mRNA. It will lead to inhibition of bacterial protein synthesis, and thereby it will produce an antibacterial or bactericidal action. So that is the mechanism of action of fluoroquinolone. It will bind with the DNA gyrase in case of gram-positive bacteria, and it will bind with the DNA topoisomerase 2 in case of gram-positive bacteria. In case it will inhibit DNA by gyrase in case of gram-negative bacteria also. Thereby, by fluorinated, the spectrum will be broad, and it will be active against both gram-negative as well as gram-positive organism. And there will be a chance for resistance, and the mechanism of resistance noted so far is due to the chromosomal mutation producing DNA gyrase or topoisomerase 4, or it may be due to the reduced permeability, increased efflux of the drug across the bacterial membrane. So that is the mechanism of resistance formed by the fluoroquinolones towards different microorganisms. Now, coming to the classification of fluoroquinolone, it is mainly classified into first generation and second generation. In first generation, it includes norfloxacin, ofloxacin, perfloxacin, and ciprofloxacin. And in case of second generation, the drugs included are levofloxacin, gatifloxacin, moxifloxacin, lomifloxacin, and sparfloxacin. Now, coming to the spectrum, as we mentioned before, it is active against both gram-positive as well as gram-negative organism. And these are some examples of microorganisms which are highly susceptible to ciprofloxacin: E. coli, Klebsiella pneumonia, Enterobacter, then Salmonella typhi and Salmonella, Shigella, Proteus, Neisseria gonorrhea, Neisseria meningitis, Haemophila influenza. And moderately susceptible to some organism like Pseudomonas aeruginosa, Staphylococcus aureus, Staphylococcus epidermis. These are some examples of organisms which are susceptible and moderately susceptible organisms towards ciprofloxacin. Now, coming to the pharmacokinetics of ciprofloxacin, usually ciprofloxacin is absorbed very rapidly through oral route, but there will be some delay of absorption due to the food, and there will be a chance for first pass metabolism. And ciprofloxacin and other fluoroquinolones here are highly tissue penetrability, and concentration in lungs, sputum, muscle, bone, prostate, and phagocytes exceed that in the plasma, and these are usually excreted primarily in urine. Now, coming to the ADR of ciprofloxacin, it will produce different ADR in different systems of our body. In gastrointestinal system, it may produce nausea, vomiting, bad taste, anorexia. Usually, the gut anaerobes is not affected. It will inhibit only aerobic microorganisms. Anaerobic microorganisms are not affected by ciprofloxacin. In CNS, it will produce some adverse drug reactions like dizziness, headache, restlessness, anxiety, insomnia, impairment of concentration and dexterity. And in general, it may produce some skin hypersensitivity reaction like rashes, pruritus, photosensitivity, urticaria, and swelling of lips. These are some important adverse drug reactions of ciprofloxacin. Now, there are some drug interactions which are happened when it is concurrently used with other drugs. Since the ciprofloxacin will inhibit the metabolism of some drugs like theophylline, caffeine and warfarin, it may lead to increasing plasma concentration of this theophylline, caffeine, warfarin due to the inhibition, and it may lead to toxicity of these drugs. And NSAID may enhance the CNS toxicity of fluoroquinolone, and it may lead to seizure. Antacid, sucralfate and iron salt given concurrently will reduce the absorption of fluoroquinolones. So these are some important drug interactions of ciprofloxacin. This is an important drug in the class of fluoroquinolone, which are seen as a short note question in different university question papers. Now coming to the uses of ciprofloxacin. Because of its wide spectrum of fluoroquinolone, it will inhibit the both gram-positive as well as gram-negative microorganism, and also it will produce its bactericidal activity, and due to its oral efficacy and good tolerability, it can be used for blind therapy of any infection without knowing the type of microorganism to be killed. സോ നമ്മൾ സാധാരണഗതിയിൽ ഒരു ലാബ് ടെസ്റ്റ് ഒന്നും നടത്താതെ നമുക്കൊരു റിസൾട്ട് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ഇൻഫെക്ഷനെ ട്രീറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ട് നമ്മൾ കൊടുക്കാൻ പറ്റുന്ന ഒരു ഫസ്റ്റ് ചോയ്സ് ഓഫ് ഡ്രഗ് ആയിട്ട് നമുക്ക് യൂസ് ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റുന്നതാണ് സിപ്രോഫ്ലോക്സാസിൻ. അതിൻ്റെ വൈഡ് സ്പെക്ട്രം ആക്ടിവിറ്റി ഉണ്ടായതുകൊണ്ടാണ്. ഓക്കെ, ആൻഡ് സിപ്രോഫ്ലോക്സാസിൻ ഇസ് സ്പെസിഫിക്കലി യൂസ്ഡ് ഫോർ സം യൂറിനറി ട്രാക്ട് ഇൻഫെക്ഷൻ ആൻഡ് ആൾസോ ഫോർ ദ ട്രീറ്റ്മെൻറ്റ് ഓഫ് ഗോണോറിയ. യൂഷ്വലി ആൻഡ് സിംഗിൾ ഡോസ് ഓഫ് 500 mg ഡോസ് വിൽ നിയർലി ക്യൂർ 100% ക്യൂർ ഇൻ gonorrhea. Then it can be used for the treatment of chancroids. 50 mg BD for 3 days is used, and also it is used for bacterial gastroenteritis and treatment of typhoid, and also treatment of bone, soft tissue, gynecological wound infections and respiratory tract infection, even though it is not used as a primary drug choice. And it can be used as a secondary line of anti-tubercular drugs for the treatment of tuberculosis, and it is also used for the treatment of gram-negative septicemia, meningitis and conjunctivitis. Ciprofloxacin is available as eye drops, and which is the important drugs which are used for the conjunctivitis. സാധാരണ ചെങ്കണ്ണ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ കണ്ടീഷൻസിലൊക്കെ നമ്മൾ യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്ന ഒരു ഐ ഡ്രോപ്പ് ആണ് സിപ്രോഫ്ലോക്സാസിൻ, വിച്ച് ഈസ് അവൈലബിൾ ഇൻ ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് ബ്രാൻഡ് നെയിംസ് ലൈക്ക് സിപ്ലോക്സ്. ദ മോസ്റ്റ് ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ് വൺ ഇസ് ഫ്രം ദ മാനുഫാക്ചറർ സിപ്ല, സിപ്ലോക്സ് ഐ ഡ്രോപ്സ്, സിപ്ലോക്സ് ഡി വിത്ത് സിപ്രോഫ്ലോക്സാസിൻ ആൻഡ് ഡെക്സാമെത്തസോൺ. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് യൂസ്ഡ് ഫോർ ദ ട്രീറ്റ്മെൻറ് ഓഫ് കൺജക്റ്റിവൈറ്റിസ്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഓൾ അബൌട്ട് ദ ഡെഫിനിഷൻ, classification, mechanism of action, adverse effects and uses of quinolones and fluoroquinolones, especially ciprofloxacin. Hope it is clear. Thank you for watching this video.